In this video, I will discuss about dry eye. Let's start with introduction. Dry eye is a condition in which a person doesn't have enough quality tears to lubricate and nourish the eye. Tears are necessary for maintaining the health of the front surface of the eye and for providing clear vision. When our eye blinks, it spreads the tear, which provide lubrication and reduce risk of infection, remove the debris, keep surface smooth and clear. Now let's study about mechanism of dry eye. The four interrelated mechanisms thought to be responsible for manifestation of dry eye. 1. Tear instability. 2. Tear hyperosmolarity. 3. Inflammation. And 4. Ocular surface damage. Inflammation in the conjunctiva, accessory gland and ocular surface is present in 80% of patients with any kind of dry eye. Let's start with classification. A. Aqueous deficient. Sjögren syndrome dry eye. Sjögren syndrome is an autoimmune inflammatory disease of which dry eye is a feature. Non-Sjögren syndrome dry eye. 1. Lacrimal deficiency. It may be primary deficiency due to age-related dry eye, congenital lacrima, or may be secondary deficiency due to AIDS, lacrimal gland ablation, nerve ablation. 2. Lacrimal gland duct obstruction due to trachoma, chemical injury, or Steven-Johnson syndrome. 3. Reflex hyposecretion. May be sensory due to contact lens wear, diabetes, refractive surgery. Or may be motor block due to seventh cranial nerve damage, systemic drugs. B. Evaporative. 1. Intrinsic factor. Meibomian gland deficiency due to posterior blepharitis, disorder of lid aperture due to excessive scleral show, lid retraction, proptosis, facial nerve palsy, low blink rate due to reading, using mobile and computer, drug action, antihistamine, antispasmodics, diuretics. 2. Extrinsic factor. A. Vitamin A deficiency. B. Tropical drugs including the effect of preservatives. C. Contact lens wear. D. Ocular surface disease such as allergic conjunctivitis. Now let's study about cause of dry eye. Age: over 65 years. Gender: female is more than male due to pregnancy, oral contraceptives, menopause. Medications: antihistamine, antihypertensive, antidepressants. Medical conditions: 1. Ocular conditions, inflammation of the eyelids, inflammation of the surfaces, the inward or outward turning of eyelids. 2. Others: rheumatoid arthritis, diabetes, thyroid problems. Environmental conditions: 1. Exposure to smoke, wind, dry climates. 2. Failure to blink regularly, using screen for long periods of time. Other factors: long-term use of contact lenses, refractive eye surgeries. Let's start with clinical features. Symptoms of dry eye: feelings of dryness, grittiness, and burning sensation that characteristically worsen over the course of the day. Stringy discharge, transient blurring of vision, redness, and crusting of lids are also common. Sensitivity to light, difficulty with nighttime driving, foreign body sensation, watery eyes, which is the body's response to the irritant of dry eyes. Lack of emotional or reflex tearing is unusual. Now, sign of dry eye. 1. In eyelid, posterior blepharitis, meibomian gland dysfunction. 2. In conjunctiva, redness, staining with fluorescent and rose bengal, keratinization, conjunctivocalysis. 3. In tear film. In the normal eye, when the tear film breaks down, the mucin layer becomes contaminated with lipid but is washed away. In dry eye, the lipid contaminated mucin accumulates in the tear film as particles and debris that move with each blink. The marginal tear meniscus. In the normal eye, the meniscus is 0.2 to 0.4 mm in height, but in dry eye, it becomes thin or absent. 4. In cornea, punctate epithelial erosion that stain well with fluorescein, filaments stain well with rose bengal but less with fluorescein. Mucus plug occurs in severe dry eye. Now let's study about investigation of dry eye. The aim of the investigation is to confirm and quantify a clinical diagnosis of dry eye. The test measures the following parameters. 1. Stability of the tear film. This is analyzed by tear breakup time. 2. Tear production. This is analyzed by Schirmer test, fluorescein clearance, tear osmolarity. 3. Ocular surface disease. This is analyzed by corneal stain, impression cytology. There is no clinical test to confirm the diagnosis of evaporative dry eye. Diagnosis is based on the presence of associated clinical findings. Treatment of dry eye. 1. Treatment strategy. The causative processes of dry eye are generally not reversible, and management is therefore control of symptoms and the prevention of surface damage. According to Dry Eye Workshop, suggested treatment option depend on level of severity of disease graded from 1 to 4. 2. Tear substitutes. Tear substitutes have a relatively simple formation that cannot approximate the components and structure of normal tear film. There are no mucus substitutes, and paraffin is only an approximation to the action of tear lipids. Available forms are A. Drops and gels. 1. Cellulose derivatives, as for example hypromellose, methyl cellulose. 2. Carbomar gels. These adhere to the ocular surface and so are longer lasting. 3. Polyvinyl alcohol. This increases the persistence of the tear film and is useful in mucin deficiency. B. Ointments containing petroleum mineral oil can be used at bedtime to supplement daytime drops. C. Eyelid spray contain a liposome based agent that may stabilize the tear film and reduce evaporation. D. Artificial tear insert emplaced once or twice daily offer extended duration of treatment and are preferred by some patients. E. Mucolytic agents. Acetylcysteine 5% drop may be useful in patients with corneal filaments and mucus plugs. F. Non-preservatives drops. Numerous non-preserved drops are now available, including some multi-dose products. 3. Punctal occlusion. Punctal occlusion reduces drainage and thereby preserves natural tears and prolongs the effect of artificial tears. It is of greatest value in patients with moderate to severe dry eye who have not responded to frequent installation of topical agent. Punctal occlusion are of three types. 1. Temporary occlusion. 2. Reversible prolonged occlusion. 3. Permanent occlusion. 4. Anti-inflammatory agents. A. Topical steroids. Low intensity preparations such as fluromethylone. B. Omega fatty acid supplements, as for example omega 3 fish oil, flax seed oil. C. Oral tetracyclines to control associated blepharitis, especially meibomianitis. D. Topical cyclosporins reduces T cell mediated inflammation of lacrimal tissue, resulting in an increase in the number of globular cells and reversal of squamous metaplasia of conjunctiva. 5. contact lenses. A low water content HEMA lenses may be successfully fitted to moderately dry eyes. B silicone rubber lenses that contain no water and readily transmit oxygen are effective in protecting the cornea in extreme tear film deficiency. C occlusive gas permeable scleral lenses provide a reservoir of saline over the cornea and can be worn on an extremely dry eye with exposure. 6. Optimization of environmental humidity. Reduction of room temperature, room humidifiers, moist chamber goggles or side shields to glasses. 7. Miscellaneous options. A. Botulinum toxin injection in the orbicularis muscles may help control the blepharospasm that often occurs in severe dry eye. B. Oral cholinergic agonist may reduce symptoms of dry eye and dry mouth in patients with Sjögren's syndrome. C. Submandibular gland transplantation for extreme dry eye and may produce excessive levels of mucus in the tear film. D. Serum eye drops, autologous or umbilical cord serum. They may aid the healing of persistent epithelial defects. The next video, I will discuss about tear breakup time. Stay with Smart Optometry.